Hello and welcome. Today I have a bunch of interesting Quest news for you. First, I want to show you a very special Quest 2 I recently bought. You might ask, what's so special about it? I mean, it looks like any other Quest 2. And you would be totally right with that. What makes this one special is that a meta repair technician forgot to lock its bootloader, which means that I can now install any operating system I want on it, and easily get root. For future videos, I will try to do a bunch of tests with it, whether I can overclock it, change the boot logo, increase the Guardian size, or whatever comes to mind. Let me know in the comments if you have any idea what I could try on it. The possibilities are pretty much endless. By the way, thanks again to my supporters on Ko-Fi, you are the reason why I was able to buy the Quest. Also, it turns out that there are possibly a few hundred of these unlocked Quest 2s out there in the wild, and you will possibly find one of them when looking through some VR subreddits. Then there's SuperRes, which Samulia, Setlius, Bradley and I found in our Quest system library. It seems, like the name suggests, to be a way to have super resolution on the Quest utilizing some machine learning method. Because of its name, T-Rex, it could possibly be that this is DigiLens' T-Rex solid-state wobulation technology. Wobulation means that they quickly move the location a screen displays an image from to create a higher res, or as you may call it, super res, image that eliminates the screen door effect while taking up little space and only requiring a low resolution display. This would explain why their C-Pride prototype, a variation of C-Cliff, only had a 3K micro OLED display with 30 ppd at 100 FOV per eye, while the human eye resolution is around 60 ppd. It could also explain why the headset in a picture of Mark Zuckerberg with a supposedly human eye resolution prototype is only so small, and not as big as, let's say, a Pimax. Sadly, it's Bradley has also made a fantastic in-depth video on this. Definitely check it out after this video. I also have an update on face and eye tracking. Since V38 apps can now request the permission to use face and eye tracking data to use in-game. I guess this is because game developers have started to receive C-Cliff preview devices to integrate into their games. Another piece of evidence that makes this more likely is that for a brief period, the Oculus mobile app showed a C-Cliff device when logging in with a Facebook test account. Meta is currently testing their own brand of Airlink Bridge Dongle, which can presumably be used to use Airlink with optimal network conditions without needing a dedicated router that supports Wi-Fi 6. This has been found by Kaitlyn, who you should definitely follow on Twitter, in the Oculus driver updater. You might have already seen some articles about this, but what they haven't told you about is that there are multiple different dongles being worked on, and it's not just the one dongle by D-Link. There are in total 5 different drivers, one for the D-Link Air Bridge, that has already been posted a lot, two with a Realtek RTL 8852 chip, one for one other D-Link USB dongles, and one Asus dongle. Something surprising to see in firmware is that Meta has planned a small event for Earth Day 2022, which is later this month, on April 22. It seems like they will unlock a new treehouse environment. I originally thought it was this one from Mark Zuckerberg's post on Facebook, but that's already called Mountain Study, so it could very well be a different environment. The event also includes a video about environmental protection. You can actually watch the video right now by typing in the following command. Last but not least, there have also been 5 new options added to vrLauncher, and one removed in V38, with no changes in V39. But they are really uninteresting, so as always, you can try them yourself by downloading the latest vrLauncher release from my GitHub. Thanks for watching this video, join my Discord or support me on Ko-fi. If you feel any questions, ask me in the comment section, and I will see you next time. Bye!